Hello all, I'm Viru from electronicsinnovation.com. I'm your host for this episode. In this video, we will try to make a single channel gateway with Wemos D1 Mini Pro and RFM95 module. First of all, we will make hardware for the gateway. Then we will program it. Later, we will register the gateway on the Things Network server. Finally, we will test the gateway with the LoRa END nodes we have developed in earlier tutorials. So, let's quickly jump into the episode. Here is the hardware circuit for the single channel gateway. I made this to interface RFM95 module and Wemos D1 Mini Pro module. I made these solid connections by following the circuit diagram as shown here. Let's place the modules in their respective places. RFM95 sits in its position. Now it's time for Wemos D1 Mini Pro to sit in the desired position. Finally, the antenna is also connected to the Wemos D1 Mini Pro. Before jumping into the programming part, I would like to take a moment and thank PCBs.com for sponsoring this project by sending these external PCBs. This RFM95 module is not breadboard friendly. So, I have designed an external PCB and ordered it on PCBs.com. PCBs.com is an online PCB manufacturing enterprise which provides all services you need to make hardware for your IoT or embedded devices. If you have a similar requirement, do check out their website for more details. The link is in the description below. I have bought this waterproof casing for this project. If you would like to place this device outdoor, the casing will protect the device from the weather. After installing the circuit inside of the casing, it will look something like this. I have made a hole on top of the casing to secure the antenna as shown here. I have also made another hole in the bottom of the casing to provide the power supply and also connect the programming cable to the Wemos D1 Mini Pro. Finally, the enclosure can be closer like this. So that's it. The hardware for the single channel gateway is ready. Now let's jump into the programming part. First of all, visit the GitHub repository using the link provided in the description below. Then download the code as shown here. Once the file is downloaded successfully, extract it. Then open the folder. Here, we got two folders, one is library and the other is LoRaWAN Gateway. We will use this code to program our Wemos D1 Mini Pro as single channel gateway with Arduino IDE. Before that, we need to copy the following libraries to the Arduino libraries folder. Select all the libraries present in the folder and copy them. Then go to the Arduino/libraries directory and simply paste them. After completing this process, come back to the LoRaWAN Gateway folder and open the .ino file with Arduino IDE. This is the code for the single channel gateway. Before uploading this code to the Wemos D1 Mini Pro, first we need to make sure that we have installed ESP8266 boards plugin in the Arduino IDE. For that, go to the preferences from the file menu and make sure you have added the following link in the Additional Boards Manager URL. You can find this link in the description below. Then go to the following directory, Tools, Boards and Boards Manager. Now search for ESP8266 and install the 2.7.1 version. There are latest versions also available, but this code is not tested with the newest versions. So I suggest using the following version. Then close the window. Then go to the following directory, Tools, Boards and ESP8266 Boards, and you will find the LoRaWAN Wemos D1 Mini Pro. Select that particular board. Then go to the next tab in the Arduino IDE. Now scroll down. Here you need to pay attention. Once the code is uploaded to the gateway, it will create an access point with the following SSID and password. If you wanted to make your gateway secured, you can change the credentials from here. If you wanted to make the gateway directly connected to the available Wi-Fi network in the client mode, You can give the same network credentials here, but this thing can be done from the web portal itself. So I'm not using it right now. That's it. You don't have to worry about anything else. Everything in this code is pre-configured. Now connect the gateway to the laptop using the any USB interface. Then check the uploading configurations, ports, LoRaWAN Wemos D1 Pro and select the right port. Keep the rest of the settings default as shown here. Then hit the uploading button. Once the uploading process is completed, open the serial monitor with 9600 baud rate. If you see the following text on the serial monitor, starting WAN system, OK, and starting LoRa module, OK. Congratulations, you have successfully programmed the single channel gateway with the firmware. Now the gateway will create an access point with the following name. This is the same thing we have already discussed. Now we can connect to the access point and configure the gateway to talk with the Things network server. But that is a little bit lengthy process. So I have decided to make one separate video on that. You can find that video link in the above I button or on the end cards of the video. See you on that video. Bye bye.